Good morning, Facebook Live. This is Robin Kirby-Gette. Welcome to today. It is February the 2nd, 2021. I'm still having difficulty grasping that it's 2021. Is that just not absolutely amazing? And we are already into February. Oh my goodness. This year has just started off in a sprint. Speaking of sprints, you're going to start off in a sprint today. As we talk about walking with wisdom, and one of the things God has really put on my heart, especially to those in the faith of Christ Jesus, to walk in more balance with words. Words. How important are words? They're so important. Amen. And so one of the things that God has really put on my heart, and one of the things that He does with me in writing, and of course, God has given me the gift to write what He has put on my heart so that it can be teachings to inspire, edify, bring holiness to the body of Christ Jesus. And we're talking about the self-image, right? The self-image goes from glory to glory as we behold God with an unveiled face, as we behold His glory with an unveiled face. And remember, the root word for glory is dokeo. It comes from doxa. It's dokeo, and it means thoughts and opinions. And so as our thoughts and opinions become holy, become the higher way of thinking, Isaiah 35:8, that highway of holiness, right? God is able to do exceedingly abundantly above all that we can think or imagine according to that power, amen? And so one of the things that He wants me to edify you with is words, 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 words. And I talk about it in my new book, to the degree that you have a broader vocabulary, okay? And I want to really stretch you. A broader vocabulary is the degree that you have a fullness of God moods, okay? You can either have a bad mood or a good God mood, amen? And so in order to have such a fullness of appreciation for a God mood, a good mood, you want to increase and enlarge your vocabulary. And the first scripture that comes to mind, of course, or scriptures, is Isaiah 54:1-3. Enlarge the curtains of your habitation. Lengthen your cords, strengthen your stakes. And it is God bringing a depth of broadness of who He is in His presence to His people. And so one of the things that really edifies you and facilitates that God mood is your vocabulary, your words, and choosing the words you use with yourself and with others. Don't just use words mishaply, or, you know, use them just for the sake of your language, of just hearing yourself speak, okay? If your words don't have a depth of God in it, of the fruit of Holy Spirit, then it is idle. It is idle. And we're going to have to give account for those words before Christ Jesus. And you know, saints, I was thinking the other day, I was really under the anointing of the fear of the Lord, of the spirit of the fear of the Lord. And God was just bringing me such exhortation, conviction, chastisement, not just for myself, but for the body of Christ Jesus, to really walk circumspectly and to choose your words wisely. And this is what the prophet experienced, Isaiah, in Isaiah 6, as his lips were speaking that he was unclean and of a people in the midst of them that was unclean. And what was he talking about? What came off their lips? You see, because nobody knew Isaiah in the secret place. Isaiah probably thought he was the most righteous at the time, and he probably judged people out of his own hearts, and he needed Isaiah 6, just like Paul needed a road to Damascus. Saul needed a road to Damascus to become Paul. And Paul means little. It means humble, okay? And so Saul needed to be humbled at the road to Damascus because Saul needed grace. He needed to choose his words wisely because with words, he was ordering the brutality and the execution of other Christians. And you know, because of grace, Jesus Christ, that the bar is higher. The standard is higher. No longer do we have to get a weapon to really harm somebody, but we can harm people by what is in our heart, and what is in our heart comes out of our mouth. Jesus talks about that in Matthew 12, 33 through 36, that it comes out of the mouth. It's not also what goes into the mouth that defiles the man. It's what comes out of the mouth that defiles the man. And what I see so many times, and you know, I'm saying it even about myself, is that people use words haphazardly. That was the word that was coming to me earlier, haphazardly. And they do not give account. They do not give accountability for the words that they use. And it is so important. And so one of the things to aid you, to facilitate you in having God words to use, is to broaden your vocabulary. So what do I mean? You know, saints of God, we have got a dictionary that has a gazillion words in it. And if you look at The Professor and the Madman, which is a movie that we all know, which is the true story of the English dictionary that came into being by a man who gave his life, who was an autodidact, who didn't have a degree, but had gazillions of languages as an expert, and gave his life to create the dictionary. And so if we look at a man that gave his life to bring us words, and to give us a depth of language in order to express ourselves more accurately. You know what we can do? Because Paul was learned of the time. He knew about the philosophers. He knew about what all the different knowledges of categories were talking about in Athens. And that's why the philosophers drug him to Mars Hill, and they wanted to listen to him, because he spoke a language that they could understand. He spoke with passion, and he spoke with an anointing in a manner in which they could understand it and relate in their language. And so increase your vocabulary. Get in the dictionary, and you know what? Go after bigger words. Don't just go after great. Maybe look at great and what the word great is used in, like magnanimous, phenomenal, ostentatious. Get in there and use massive words, because to the degree that your vocabulary is expanded is the degree that you will appreciate a God mood. You will appreciate the strength of expression in your body, which is your emotions and your thoughts, and you will be able to meditate on that which is lovely, good report, kind, Philippians 4:8, true and noble. Well, there are many noble words in the dictionary that can expound on the word happy. There are many more words for happy than you have experienced or expressed in your own life. So I want to challenge you, get in the dictionary just for 1 minute a day and learn a new word. God bless you. I love you.